everyone and welcome back to our channel. I hope you all are doing well. In today's video, we have with us the 2021 Suzuki Gixxer. Special thanks to Dhone Suzuki for providing us this bike for this review. You can visit their dealership for best offers in Pune on Suzuki products. And don't worry, because they are following all the safety guidelines issued by the government. And if you are new to our channel, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and ring the bell so you never miss an update from Rev Explorers. You can also go ahead and check out our Instagram page. The handle is right over here. Follow us there. We are also available on Facebook and Twitter. Now let's begin with the review of the Suzuki Gixxer. In 2019, all the four Gixxers got a revamp, which brought in the LED headlights. With that, you have the traditional bulb turn indicators and telescopic front forks. The front tire is mounted on a 17-inch black-coated alloy wheel, and the tire size is 100x80. Now, this is an MRF tire, but it is not a radial one, like you get to see in the Gixxer 250s. Along with that, you get a 280mm disc brake in the front with Biber calipers, and it has single-channel ABS. From the side profile, it still looks like the old Gixxer. And this red color really looks good. Now it gets a split seat, which is comfortable enough for the rider as well as the pillion. Along with that, the Gixxer SF gets a 12 liter fuel tank and has a claimed fuel efficiency of 45 kmpl, and below the fuel tank is a 155cc air cooled fuel injected motor, which is mated with a 5-speed gearbox and churns out a maximum power of 13.6 PS at 8000 rpm and a peak torque of 13.8 Nm at 6000 rpm. The complete bike weighs 141 kgs and has a ground clearance of 160 mm, which is decent enough for your city usage, and you can in fact take it out on the weekends. You get a 7-step adjustable monoshock in the rear for better riding experience, although it is on the stiffer side when used in stock configuration. Oh, by the way, here is our twin muffler. Let's check out how it sounds. At the rear is a 140x60 MRF Revs, which is a radial tire mounted on a 17-inch black-coated alloy wheel. Along with that, you get a 220mm disc brake, which does not get ABS assistance because it is a single-channel ABS setup. At the tail end are bulb-style turn indicators. Along with that is a V-shaped LED tail light. Now let's hop on to the saddle. The saddle height is 790mm. The saddle is slightly stiff, but you will be able to manage because it is a naked sports bike. Now let's check out the instrument cluster. It gets an all-digital instrument cluster like it has always been, but this is a different design. It gets a digital tachometer, digital speedometer, digital fuel gauge. Then you have the gear position indicator, time, and the trip and odometers. That's it. This is the RPM limiter. And then you have turn indicator, EFI malfunction indicator, and the ABS indicator. Coming to the right hand side, you have the kill switch and the self start switch. On the left hand side is the pass switch, the headlight control, the turn indicator control, and the horn. A very loud single tone horn. Now let's take it on a ride. And before we go on a ride, I should tell you that these mirrors are just like the Gixxer 250. They are very good, they are big, and they have a curvature to remove the blind spot. Now let's take it on a ride on the city roads of Pune. And before you go on a ride, don't forget to wear your helmet and follow all road safety rules. Have never expected that this split seat would be so comfortable, because the first generation had a single seat and yet it was very stiff and uncomfortable. But now the story has changed. Overall, the seating ergonomics are just like Gixxer 250. Big tank to grab on, wide seat with curvature in the rear making it sporty, low set wide handlebar, and the slightly rear set foot pegs all combines to an aggressive riding posture, just like a naked sports bike should have. The BS6 compliance has definitely helped the engine in becoming more refined and advanced with the fuel injection system. However, this has costed us power marginally, but it is not really making a big difference, because the initial pickup of the bike is still good and it pushes well through the mid-range. Although it becomes flat at the top, but that has always been the Gixxer character. On the brighter side, the bike is lighter than all its segment rival except the FZ, and in that case also, it is few kgs heavier only. But this lightweight against the RTR 160 and NS 160 helps Gixxer to attain better power to weight ratio, and with that it can promise better fuel efficiency. The motor is very smooth and refined. The vibrations can only be felt at the top, and those are also minimum. I feel the engine is good for city use as well as highway cruising. The engine is coupled with a 5-speed unit, and I don't know why, but this gearbox is slightly on a stiffer side. You get a clicky feel, which is good, but gear shifts feel slightly hard. The gearbox is precise and the clutch is on a lighter side with optimum travel. So it becomes easy to conquer the urban jungle on this motorcycle. The motorcycle gets a single channel ABS and the brakes perform well. With the introduction of Biber in the rear, the brakes have slightly improved. They still lack the feedback, but the stopping power is good. The front brakes are really amazing. Good stopping power and feedback, inspiring good confidence in you. As always, the suspensions are stiff on this motorcycle, and it is the most stiffest setup than all the other motorcycles in this segment, which for me is a blessing because it is super stable on straight stretches and super fun to take it into the corners. You need not worry if you are using it in the city, they are good for small bumps and potholes, and you can always get the rear one adjusted according to your comfort. This is a good, smooth and refined machine, delivering good fuel efficiency with good performance figures. It can strike you as a balance between the two worlds. The only point of improvement is the switchgear, but that is also not a deal breaker. Our ride with the Suzuki Gixxer has come to an end, and all I can say is it is a very decent bike to have. It gives you good fuel economy and has a decent power, better than the Yamaha competition, but less than the other competition. Anyways, if you like this Gixxer, you can get it too at Rs 1.16 lakh ex-showroom Delhi, and it is available in 5 different colors. Red one is my favorite now. I hope you did like this video, do give it a thumbs up, and if you are new to our channel, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and ring that bell so you never miss an update from Rev Explorers. You can also go ahead and check out our social media pages on Instagram, Facebook and Twitter. I can sing it all day long. If you still have any doubts or any queries, leave it in the comment section below or directly get in touch with us on our social media pages. Last but not the least, we'll see you again in the next video. Till that time, stay home, stay safe, ride safe. Bye-bye.